wish I knew why I'm so in love with you. You know, if I'm doing a play or a concert, of course, it's a much more structured thing, but often part of the reason that I crowd surf is this sort of challenge of engagement of what has sadly become a safe space rather than a sacred, jubilant place. And it's been fascinating because I often crowd surf just because it's so ridiculous to have a woman in a ball dress, you know, kind of throwing herself on the audience. But it's so interesting who will choose to touch you, who will watch you slowly descend, but still having the best night ever, but they don't think you're real. So I'm often sort of screaming, I'm real, I'm not a television. And I do it obviously in a comedy way, but at the same time, it's very revealing about the expectations audiences have when they come into the live theatre now. I think we all perform all the time and just pretend that we're not. And so I've just embraced that perhaps in a... to really kind of feel the joy of performance and the... You know, we live in fake ways, and I think there's something very real about living in a heightened way or embracing the fact that we're all performing ourselves all the time. So this is not a calculated thing, but I think it's a true thing in my heightened state.
Oh, stop! Okay.
So I think at its best, it connects you with humanity and, you know, reminds you of your commonality and your difference. And it's survival. I think for me it's profound to my existence, from the act of breathing to the spiritual enlightenment of it. It's rare. So those moments, I mean, I can think of them when I've heard a ballerina gasping on stage and felt so excited because it made sense that she was and showing this. Not all just perfect and silent and beautiful, she was so human. It's why I love Patti Griffin's song, All the Girls. She's a brilliant songwriter, and I sing that song often because when I sing that similarly, I feel like I'm just, you know, obviously I'm a performer, I'm performing it, and I know how to hit the emotional marks of it, but I still feel every time that it's a new song. I feel like it's a prayer for humanity. It's so gentle. It's just talking about girls waiting on the telephone, girls on the corner, girls in beauty shops, girls' tongues catching the raindrops. It's so beautiful. And the whole message of it is just be careful. And I think that's really, for all of my, you know, hysteria and hilarity on stage, that's really all I'm trying to do all the time as a performer, is just be, you know, we're real, we're not televisions. We're all these complicated bundles of nerves. Be careful with each other. In the very, quite desperately sad situations, I think I've felt that I've learnt that art is so necessary, and it's not an elitist affectation, it's not... It's so fundamental that in periods of great crisis, there must be a requiem. The music it doesn't save you, but it's around me. I don't feel it separately. And I think the only good thing that has come out of some deep tragedy has been that I've thought this is real, and the part of me that needs to have music is real, or look at images of beauty is real, and it's not something... I mean, I'm sure it was nurtured in me, but it's so fundamental. And there's sort of a relief, so much about the human experience. It's so funny. You can be sitting so in such a alone space and feel... That's what I want to do on stage, I guess, is for people to feel joy.